If I Were You by Douglas James. If I Were You is a very interesting play with a very surprising end. The play is set in a small cottage in the wilds of Essex in which lives Gerard, a well-educated playwright. He's all set to go somewhere. While he is busy packing his bag, an intruder enters his cottage with a gun in his hand. Gerard welcomes him with confidence. Seeing Gerard to be a nonchalant, he points the gun at Gerard and threatens him.
"Stop acting smart, man, or I will shoot you. Sit down there and listen to me."
The intruder informs him,
"I'm being chased by the police and I have murdered a policeman."
He further says,
"While I was in the town, I saw you and heard from people that you hardly meet anyone and order your things on phone. Since both of us are of the same height and build, I thought of a plan. I have come here to kill you and live on your identity in this peaceful cottage."
The intruder wants to know the details about Gerard before killing him so that he could imitate him well. He inquires about his car and the visitors who come to his house. Gerard is not at all afraid of the intruder and he very calmly answers all the questions in a nonchalant manner. He quickly conceives a false story to dodge the intruder and save his own life. He tells the intruder,
"I too am a murderer and the police have evidence against me. If you steal my identity, even then you would be chased by the police."
He further reveals,
"I am carrying false mustaches so that I can disguise myself and hide from the police. Unfortunately, one of my men has been arrested and certain things are recovered, which my men should have burned. I sensed that the police could raid my house tonight. Therefore, I was packing my bag and was ready to escape. I have also positioned an accomplice on the road to warn me of any danger."
At that very moment, the phone rings and Gerard shouts,
"The time has come to leave this place forever. Police can reach here anytime. You can come with me in my car."
He fools the intruder to believe him by saying,
"If you feel that I am lying, you can kill me in the car."
The intruder doubts Gerard's story. So, Gerard asks him to peep out through the door of the garage to see the police for himself. In fact, the door is that of a cupboard. As the intruder bends forward, Gerard pushes him inside the cupboard and locks it. The intruder rattles the door from inside and shouts,
"Let me out of here!"
Gerard calls the sergeant in order to hand over the intruder to the police.